Yes, she's there. Hi, Somporn. Good to see you. Thank you for being with us. We were just talking about the importance of sharing and teaching, and I think that Somporn's work is perhaps the most mind-blowing example of this. She's working in Thailand, where she is a self-taught artist, a designer, a model, a dealer of antiques, but above all, a teacher of women and children and other people, I think. So your work involves so many elements, and we're so excited to hear more about what you do. And of course, we all have many pieces in our wardrobe of your beautiful clothes. So I wish I had one on today, but I will look forward to getting it out for the summer. So thank you, Somporn. Just need to unmute.
สวัสดีค่ะ My name is Somporn Intalapayong. I come from Thailand. I want to thank International Folk Art Market, Lee Edgecourt, Philip Pimano for invite me to speak today. I come from Nakhon Sawan province in Thailand. When I young, I live and I went to school to with my auntie house, and I take care myself. I do everything by myself. I learn how to sewing the clothes by myself, and I help my auntie to take care home and sell the things what she sell. And when I start to do working, like I cut my clothes, that time is I'm 12 years old. And in that days, the people in Thailand, they thought a girl doesn't want to start have education a lot because she will go to marry. After marry, husband will take care of her. I tell my mom, oh, I don't want to marry. I want to work. If you don't have money to support me, I will find a job and bring the money go to study. Between I study, I learn. When I have time, I go to volunteer people. I go to, come to work like a teacher in the north of Thailand, like a teacher in the mountain. And I do the work with the people who do the weaving and dye indigo in the small village in northeast of Thailand. Before I finished at the university, I opened the shop in the Tuchak market. I found a shop in the Tuchak market. This is the first shop. The things what I sell, I bring from when I traveling in the north and teach the children in the mountain, what I saw and order. I sell the silver baskets, textile, clothes, everything from the minority and the people from the village. Most of the thing I sell, I bring from them to sell. And before finish at university, I do like this until I finish education from a politic major, not about the textile or the clothes, never learn art. And when I opened the shop in Chatuchak Market, weekend market, they open Saturday and Sunday. Monday to Friday, I go everywhere in Thailand to find the things, bring back to Bangkok and sell. And I wear clothes what I cutting and doing by myself. When the customer come to my shop, they look at me and they say, oh, your clothes look different and more sewing and on the clothes. I said, yes, this is my, I make by myself. And she they asked me, can you make like this for me? I said, if you don't mind and you like my design, okay, I can do for you. And one day, one man, a big body, and a big muscle, and big earring, and no hair, and a lot of tattoo in the body, he come to ask me, sister, can you teach me how to make the clothes for my mom? I look at him and think, oh, okay. If you intend to do for your mom, I happy. I want to tell you how to make, and they come to learn with me. I teach him how to make the clothes, my style, what I do long time. I learn how to make clothes by myself. When I have small piece of the clothes, I go make by, I do my style. And after that day, I open my shop to teach the people in front of my shop near the street. We sit down near the street and no pattern, no everything, only you bring your heart intent to work with me. I teach you the natural way. Like you don't, we don't have the pen to drawing in the clothes. I use the soap, what I have to drawing. After that, you can wash and everything gone. If you don't have, I want to cut the hollow. I bring the bowl, cover and drawing by soap and cut and you can wear. In one day, if you intend to do, you can sewing finish in your clothes. And our friend who work with me, somebody still income to work with me too. And I, the people who work with, learn with me have Qingden, youngest and oldest. Youngest is about 5 years old and oldest is 76 years old. For the Qingden, I bring them go to the park. I tell them bring the natural. We go to get the cotton flower from the tree when they go down. You can see all the Qingden, they are homeschool Qingden. We go to get the cotton, and the cotton, that one we bring to make a small piece, what they want to do, what they enjoy, or everything I give them to design by themselves. But most of them, they like, they want have to small pillow for sleeping with her work, and they continue to work, and they happy when they make finish that piece, and they talking and they enjoy the story of what they doing, and they show what how feel. She said, oh, this one I will sleep with my pillow every day, something like that. And in my group, we have many people who work with me, include with diver, sell the food in the market, farmer. And people, one lady, she is a Parkinson. She said, oh, I want to do with you, but my hand cannot control. I said, oh, never mind. If you intend to do, maybe you cannot to control your hand, maybe good design. She, some people said, oh, if I work with you, my work not beautiful. I said, if you happy to your work, please do for me. The happy will keep outside the people looking, you work well. Some people like a man, he don't know how to make, and he need work for money. I said, okay, never mind. And what that day, we sit under the tree, that's the sun shining. We look the shadow, and I said, okay. I bring one clothes under the shadow and tell him, you must be make this one. My inspiration come from natural. I follow the natural come to my work, like a shadow, tree, animal, or I give to the people work with me. In my group, I give the work for them, and them they are bring the work, go back home to work themselves. Men and women can do. If they intend to do, I only tell them, I only tell them what to do. Like I want to make a life field design. I tell you, imagine when you go to your life field, how you feel, what design, what the pattern of the life field when you do by yourself. You bring that one in your clothes and you do. And I think this style nah, make happy for family because they can cope with their children and the children look family, look mommy, work at home. Some people, some children, they want to follow and learn how to make same mom. And every year after finish from international folk art market, I go back to Thailand and I income for international folk art market, bring some money to give to the school. This school in my community, they have 35 children in the school and they have two teachers from the government. I pay money for three teachers, like help the teacher to teach the children in the school too. And we every year when they change the education, they come up. I bring the new clothes, uniform to her. We sign, we sign, we sign for every children. And we develop, repair the playground. And we have the used computer from friendship for the people who want to give to the children to pay to. And we build the friendship building, one building in school community. And every Chingen Day, every year, we bring the mask. This year we bring the mask, the toy, and the candy, what the Chingen enjoy and happy to eat, we give to them too. And we still give the scholarship to 13 Chingen to study until the end. And I want to thank you, International Folk Art Market, Lee Edicott, Philip Pimano, and the people who support my work and everything what I do. I want to show you a little bit. Like this one, my clothes. This one I borrow from the natural. Is that day I stay with my dad in my hometown. He cannot to walk. He have a wheelchair. And the lane come and the dot in the lane have a dot, 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 dot. I borrow from the dot what I see and bring that one to make this one. And some course I want to wear something, I do something wrong and I drawing. I never learn drawing. When I drawing, the face not same. Something mistake, I think if mistake I like, I still keep like this too. And every piece of my work, when I cut the clothes, I don't throw. I keep to make something, small piece and mix and can use for the necklace too. I think International Folk Art Market, Lee Edicott and Philip give me have opportunity. This opportunity don't give me alone. You all of you support to my seamstress too. The people who saw weaving the cotton, the people do indigo dye, the people make the yarn, and the children can have this opportunity too. For me, work is my life. The needle is my best friend. The opportunity have for give everybody. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Somporn. The needle is my best friend.
Yes, because when I go every week, I go back to take care of my dad. I bring my work on the train. I sit down and I enjoy like a meditation. Release everything, clear everything. And when I do happy, my work happy too. That's why we have everybody work with me, have many design, get the idea. And the children, I work the children, their freedom. They don't think too much. They only intend to do and happy what they work. That why is the best for me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Lee, you're on mute.
Somporn, I must say that you're quite modest here telling about all your social endeavors, which are amazing. But what we don't really get to see in the same time is your incredible collection. We saw a few pieces because we know, because we've been asking you to come to Paris also to exhibit with us in Hardware, our endeavor from Benin. And so we could hang out a lot and talk a lot. And I understood that your clothes are, although you're a self-made person, we can only wear these clothes with very high-end other clothes. So you can compare, you can bring these clothes together with Issey Miyake or Comme des Garçons or Rick Owens or brands like that, but you could not really wear them like everyday clothes. They are so unique, they're so spectacular. When you walk with these clothes in the street, people just arrest you every time. What is this? Where is this from? What the fuck, you know? And this is what you do. And this is what you create from your own mind with your own needle, which is your friend. And you just inspire everybody, because in a way you also say everybody can become a creator. Everybody has the power to do. And I think it's exemplary what you do. And I love 100% all about you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You give opportunity to me too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So I think that in the same studio, we also have Ghazali. Is that correct? He's going to come
on. Ghazali is on the way right now. I was told that he's being shuttled here right now, but I don't know where he is.
That's okay. I can maybe share a few images of Somporn's work if she wants to be on with us, if that's okay with her. I have about, I think, 6 or 7 images of Somporn's work. So if she's still there, maybe I can ask her about them, if that's okay with her, until we arrive.
Philip wants to ask questions.
Okay. I cry because I'm happy to tell all of you what I'm doing.
That's okay.
Yes.
Is it okay if I show a few slides of your textile at some point?
Yes.
Okay. I'm just going to... I didn't have much to work on, but...
Did you see?
I have just a few images. Yeah. So first of all, you're very famous for your ants.
Yeah. I like the ant really much because the social of the ant. The ant, they have the leader, and all together they know each other to help to make the work come to the end. They go up like this. That's why, yeah, I think this time we must be borrowed from them to do in our life.
Yeah.
That's why I make the ant a lot. And I like
the feeling. They're helping each other and working together.
Yes.
And then sometimes you do all kinds of characters, sometimes very, very big, and sometimes very, very small.
Yes. Like the human, I love very much for my imagine. I think if we need the people happy, we must to keep them first. Don't need to bring back, only keep happy, keep the good way for the people.
Yeah.
They look of course ants also, no?
They look like what, Lee?
Little ants.
They're on beautiful indigo dye, which you do, of course, there. And then in the indigo palette, you also do lots of, as you mentioned before, you never throw anything away. You're always keeping each piece of fabric, making beautiful patchworks, yes, over embroidery.
Like this piece, I keep every piece mix, and I, in Thailand, the people like number, like a lottery, make good luck number. That's why I bring the number, put in, mix everything. What when I imagine, oh, like this, make happy, in the they have more story in the fabric too.
Okay, so the numbers actually are to bring good luck.
Yes, good number, good luck number.
And then sometimes, like Lee mentioned, your pieces, they're very creative, they're very simple shapes. Sometimes you have amazing drapery, like sarawal pants and beautiful box dresses. So you have very basic shapes, but all of the interest is in the textiles. Is that how you
I show you the left-hand side piece come from the small piece what we have. When I work, I know the technique. We sewing one time. And we when we finish, we can reversible the clothes double time. And in one clothes, we can wear four times. Front side, back side, and irreversible inside and outside, not same pattern from sewing. I think we do already, we must do the best because all the clothes is my name.
What did you say?
All the clothes what we make is my name. Yeah, if I do good way, they remember my name from the clothes. And the clothes happy, my work happy too.
And customer is happy too, because then they can feel the happiness when they wear it.
Oh, thank you.
And I think this is maybe my second to last image. So this is also people embroidery on the right.
Yes, the left side, like when I look the cloth, some piece is broken. Broken, I bring that design, make in the cloth, like to show how can I do that. And the right hand side, I mix many face in the work. And I put the more technique what I can do, mix everything. I need to people look different. If I make same, it's too pain. No, have something interesting for look.
Yeah. And then here is more numbers. So are these numbers also good luck numbers, or are they telephone numbers?
Yes. You know, this one is come from Thailand lottery. And the people in Thailand wait every 15 day, happy two time.
Uh-huh.
The first day, the Thursday, one day, and 15, two time in the year, in the month, they wait when the lotto come, and listen the voice. And this one, when the lottery have already, the number come to the newspaper, I borrow that one, make my clothes. For the people, good luck, and people look, oh, this number I have already, but I not win because not same time I bought that lottery. Uh-huh. This one is a like more piece. Sometimes the people wrong things and the curve, and some people have a good way, some people not bad way. That's why I make this one.
And so I'm just going to stop sharing, but I know that a lot of people might be interested in knowing where they can get your clothing. How does somebody buy one of your pieces? Do they have to come to Thailand? Or I know that sometimes you're selling them in the folk market and also at other textile events. How is the easiest way to find your clothes? Is it in shops also?
You can look in the website. No, Facebook and Instagram, Chinalai Model.
Uh-huh. So in Chinalai Model. Okay, so I'll show people that website and then they can reach out there if they're interested.
Okay. Thank you very much, Lee Edicott. Thank you. Thank you
again.